What's up, art lovers, glass blowers? Have you ever wondered how to make a Murrine vase? Well, I'm gonna do my best to show you how. Check out this video.
So making Murrine is a tedious, fun process where you create these rods of glass and then slice them into these smaller sections that you can then arrange into a mosaic-like pattern to be blown into a vase.
These are all colorful glass rods I use to create the Murrine. I cut these glass rods on this contraption here I created for cutting canes. Then I arrange them just so on the ceramic kiln shelf. Right now I'm laying out black and white rods to create this black and white and aqua Murrine. Then I'm laying out a whole bunch of white rods to recreate this Murrine here. So my assistant Matt has heated up a bunch of aqua rods of glass, and I am heating up a mass of clear glass on the end of this punty. And I pull it out and I roll it over the aqua, and now that creates my aqua core on my Murrine. Then, when no one's looking, I roll that in a bunch of white powder and then come over and roll it again over this black and white rod setup. After I melt in all the black and white rods, I take a gather of molten clear and shape the mass of glass into a cylinder. And then I stick it to a post, which is a little bit of glass on another punty rod, and I just let the glass kind of melt onto the post. And then when it seems like it's cooled just a little, I begin stretching and pulling. And then I hand it off to Matt, and we just let it drip and walk away from each other. And then a little faster, now I'm going for a 3/4 inch thick rod of Murrine. And so once I'm about at that thickness, we lay the rod down on these wooden slats and we break it off and put it into the oven to cool down for about 12 hours. After the Murrine comes out of the oven the next day, I take it to the Murrine chopper, which I made from a Arbor press I got at Harbor Freight, and I begin slicing the Murrines for use in my vase. These are some other Murrine I made with a cobalt core and a white and turquoise outer layer. They look something like this when they're blown into a vase. Now, I've got a lot of Murrine to chop because I'm making larger vases, so if you'll excuse me, I've got some work to do. Okay, well, I finished all that cutting and I've arranged my Murrine into this beautiful mosaic-like pattern on a kiln shelf. And now I'm going to heat it up in the glory hole. Now, the glory hole is about 2,200 degrees, so it makes the glass nice and soft so that I can roll the edge of a blowpipe over it. And it will stick. Now, after I've got it stuck to the blowpipe, I bring it back from the glory hole, dust off the kiln wash, and begin closing the two ends up. Then I pick up the jacks and begin closing down the canes and Murrine into what will eventually become my bubble. I then take it back to the glory hole to reheat so that I can melt all the Murrine in and get it nice and smooth. I have a blow hose blowing through the blowpipe while I use a block so that the bubble is expanding as I'm condensing it with the block. This really helps get all the little dents closed down so I don't trap any air bubbles. Then I take a gather from the furnace, cool it on the pipe cooler, and head back to the bench to block it more. So I'm trying to make these vases pretty big, so I'm going to go back into the furnace and get another gather. And sometimes when you come out of the furnace, you gotta strip a little bit of glass off, and that makes the bubble nice and symmetrical. Brings all the glass to the tip of the bubble. And then cool the pipe, head back to the bench to block it again. So we've got the shoulder of the vase established, and now we're starting to cut in the neckline into the vase, which will allow us to break off from the blowpipe. Now, that bubble gets pretty hot, so you've got to be careful and cool the bottom a lot. So I'm having Matt blow into the pipe while I'm cooling the bottom. We're trying to puff out the shoulder a little bit. To help get that shoulder hot, I'm going to grab a fluffy torch and start cooking that shoulder a little more. And then we're gonna head back to the glory hole to reheat it. Now, the bottom's looking a little hot, so I'm gonna take it over to the marver table and get it into shape and cool it off a little more. Now that I've got it into the shape I want, I'm just going to let it get real hot and let gravity do the work. Now that we've got it all finished on the blowpipe side, we've transferred to the punty, and now we can start working the lip of the vase into a nice symmetrical top. So if you work hard and do it just right, you can get yourself a beautiful Murrine vase. And don't be discouraged if the first one doesn't come out right or hits the floor. These are never easy to create. Even when it's done and cold, you still have to finish the bottom. I'm grinding the punny off here on my lathe. But it's worth it when it's all said and done. Making Murrine is a lot of fun and a lot of hard work. But it really pays off when you finally finish a vase and get to assemble and blow out all those colorful optical pieces. I hope I've inspired you and taught you a few things, and let me know in the comments below if you want to see anything else. And please subscribe. Thanks so much.